Not much here. I'm gonna go with the Kitchen Finks. Very good aggressive card, and I'm not really missing out on anything taking it, so yeah, I'm not splashing the Sarkin ball. Wow, Skeletal Vampire. I will allow it. That card is really, really good. And the cost is pretty low to take it, so here we are. Nothing in this pack, really. Guess I'll take a Dream Spoiler Witches, but I really don't intend to put it in my deck. Here, I have a choice between Amru Seekers and Bone Splitter. I've heard from many people that Bone Splitter is highly underrated. I'm going to take Amru Seekers here for multiple reasons. The first reason is I have four Rebel Searchers, so the more the merrier. Second of all, another 3-drop really is not going to hurt, because I only have four 3-casting-cost creatures. Another reason is I have Tombstalker, Skeletal Vampire, and Una Queen of Fae, which are great late-game cards that require me to play. I intend to play 18 lands, so in a land-heavy slow deck, Bone Splitter is just not where you want to be. Here there's really nothing. I'll take an Aether Sworn Canonist that I might play. Aether Sworn Canonist is actually alright. It as a 2/2 artifact for 2, it's not very good. But the fact that your opponent now can only cast one spell a turn is actually quite relevant. In a deck like my own, it's hard for me to ever want to cast 2 spells in a turn, because I'd rather just be Rebel Searching. So the ability can affect my opponent, but even when it does, the upside is marginal. I think most of the time I'd rather have a Veteran Armor. Here I have an option between Stir the Pride and Tidehollow Sculler. I'm going to take the Sculler here because I have a Meta Boon and a Stir the Pride. I mean, my deck does have like a very large number of creatures and not many spells. So I guess 16 creatures is not that many. I mean, either way, Tidehollow Sculler really is as good as advertised. I mean, that card is just wonderful. It basically is a 2/2 that they have to kill. I'll be happy with another 5th pick Amru Scout here. Tidehollow Sculler actually works quite well with the Rebel Searchers and the late game black flying creatures that I have. Because you cast it and you just take the best form of removal they have in their hand. And either they kill it or they have no removal, so. I will take another Street Wraith for the sideboard. This deck turned out quite nicely. Ooh. Really? Did I underestimate largely the number of playables that I have? Looks as if I did. Oopsie. Where's that Gleam of Resistance? I'll play that one. And now, Test of Faith, Deep Cavern Imp, Absorb Viz, Canonist. I put the Gleam of Resistance in the deck because it's going to act as another land, but also as a card that I can delve for my Tombstalker. Kind of just want to put a Deep Cavern Imp in the deck. I have 10 total rebels and 5 of them are searchers, so having a thing that can actually do something is fine. I mean, drawing Deep Cavern Imp is really bad. You do not want to do that. But I think having it to search for is like pretty reasonable. Think I'm just gonna play it like this. Could go 9/9. I think I will. Yep.